Hurricane Michael will have some impacts on the Lowcountry. In this edition of Quintin's Close-Ups, I talk one-on-one with the Lowcountry's morning meteorologist, Josh Marthers of News 2. And be sure to download the free Quintin's Close-Ups app in your Apple or Google Play stores.
Well, meteorologist Josh Marthers. Good to see you.
Well, yes, sir. I always hate we have to run into each other when it's not usually for a good reason.
Yeah.
But that's okay. It's always good to see you, buddy.
Likewise. Well, let me talk to you about the obvious, Michael.
Yeah.
Everyone's saying, oh no, but you're saying...
You know what? It is an oh no for the Gulf of Mexico, that's for sure. I mean, this is going to probably be the biggest threat they've had, or at least the biggest hit they've taken in more than a decade. Last one to hit the Gulf Coast of Florida as a Category 3 or higher was Dennis back in 2005. So this is going to be a Dennis-like storm, most likely. We're talking in an area that is very prone to storm surge. Appalachian Bay is just, it's like a funnel. And in some of those places, that surge can go a mile in because it's just so flat. So it's going to be a big deal, we think, for our friends along the Florida Gulf Coast.
And what are the threats for us right now?
You know, the typical tropical storm threats. We're talking sustained winds, potentially a tropical storm force. I think it'll be mostly in gusts.
Okay.
Talking 45 to 55 mile per hour gusts in some of the heavier rain bands starting tomorrow night into Thursday. Good 4 to 6 inches of rain across most of the area, which, believe it or not, we can actually handle that right now because it has been so hot and dry for the past few weeks. Our soil has really dried out a lot. So we will see some pockets of flooding, I think, from heavy rain, but we're not talking about this widespread destructive flooding that we had up in North Carolina from Florence. That's just not in the cards with this one. Because it's also going to be moving. This thing's going to be hauling it to the northeast at about 20 or 30 miles per hour when it comes through the state. So it'll be in and out of here pretty quickly. The one thing that I do think we need to focus on, though, is the tornado threat. Storms that hit the Florida Panhandle and come at us from the south-southwest and north-northeast are usually fairly prolific tornado producers. And depending on how the atmosphere sets up, tomorrow and Thursday, we can have a little bit of an issue on our hands in some spots with that. Now, tropical tornadoes are very weak, they're very short-lived, and they don't do a lot of damage. But the problem is because they're short-lived, a lot of times they just pop up out of nowhere. So you really have to keep an eye on things, and that's one of the things that we're going to be watching really, really closely tomorrow and Thursday. I don't think it's an okay push the panic button moment yet, but you know, this is one of those things where we do need to at least have it in the back of our mind. You know, we could go under a tornado watch, and we could be under a tornado watch for an extended period of time.
And you talk about watches. I'm looking at this map behind you. From Edisto Beach up to McClellanville,
yep.
We have a tropical storm watch.
We have a tropical storm watch, and what that means is tropical storm force winds are possible in that area within the next 48 hours. And that's just a procedural thing. And that's what we have. Wind gusts up to 55 miles per hour, that meets the definition. That's why it's issued.
And we got to think about our friends in Georgetown, Conway, Myrtle Beach.
Yeah. We talked about that with the flooding. You know what? Up there, the damage has already been done. If you're putting another 3 to 6 inches of rain on top of that, it's going to cause some quick, short-fused flooding. But it's really not going to be something that you say a week down the road, all of this water comes back. That shouldn't happen with this type of setup.
And 3 to 4 weeks from now, what should we be looking for as far as the tropics?
I actually think that there's going to be something similar to what we're seeing right now with Michael, possibly within the next week or two again. That little corner of the Caribbean is prime this time of year. If we're going to get big-time development that's usually, if it's going to be a direct threat to the United States, it's going to come out of that area where Michael formed and come up into the Gulf of Mexico or come across Cuba into the Bahamas. So we still need to watch that area because it's going to be prime for about the next 2 or 3 weeks. We could see something else try to form there. I would say maybe in about 10 days from now, it may be ready to go again. We're at least, though, starting to see some movement on the weather map to where we're trying to break down this really hot weather pattern that we've had. So at least in the next couple of weeks, I think we're going to get a couple of shots of some cooler air. But still, it's going to be fairly warm. We're talking near or slightly above average temperatures for the most part.
That's good. And okay. We did go back to Michael. obviously this is coming from, you know, the panhandle of Florida. It's not, for us, it's not coming from the Atlantic Ocean, so right. We shouldn't be that worried.
We won't have to worry about that storm surge threat. We won't have to worry about that damaging wind, those destructive hurricane force winds. But we're going to get a pretty good thump out of this here for about a 24-hour period. It's going to be something that you notice, that's for sure.
Well, the Lowcountry's morning meteorologist, Josh Marthers, thank you for your time.
Always good to see you, buddy.
Likewise.